Hi, today I want to talk about three different things and explain the relationship among them. The first one is internet and how it might change in the future. The second one is how I made $300 by just installing and running an app on my PC. And the third and last one is Minecraft. I know that they are in very related things, but I promise that everything will make sense in some minutes. Anyway, let me go back home and tell you a story.
This is the story of the internet. The internet, in the most literal sense, is just a mesh of wires connecting computers throughout the world. In the whole history of our species, it is the single most significant invention in terms of its ability to connect us to each other and change virtually every aspect of the human experience. The internet, as we know today, was at least 40 years in the making. But how and by who was it created? What if I told you that the internet as you know it wasn't created, at least by a single person or institution? It just happened. Let's go back to 1958. The world is in the midst of the Cold War, which sparks the battle between the scientists of the Eastern and Western blocs. Soviets just launched the Sputnik 1, the first artificial Earth satellite. In response to that, the United States forms an Advanced Research Project Agency, ARPA. The concept of connecting multiple computers to the same network wasn't that groundbreaking at the time. Such infrastructures, called Wide Area Networks, or WAN, emerged in the 50s. WAN, as a concept, is quite straightforward. It is literally just a bunch of connected computers, and the internet, as you know today, can be considered a huge one. In the 60s, one of the directors of ARPA, J.C. R. Licklider, drew inspiration from this concept and proposed the idea of a global network. In 1869, the first connection of internet was established. The network was called ARPANET, and it was the very first version of internet. Once the first link was established between the University of California, Los Angeles, and the Stanford Research Institute, they tried to send the first message. It wasn't a photo or even a sentence. It was just a word. L-O-G-I. And the whole system crashed.
That first lousy transmission marked the beginning of arguably the greatest human invention ever. After that, ARPANET started to spread. And it was not long before other networks followed it. But with the emergence of new networks in new parts of the world, scientists ran into a problem.
Different networks had different protocols, essentially meaning that they talked in different languages. Just like a French speaker couldn't talk via telephone with a Korean speaker without a common language. Although connected, ARPANET couldn't communicate with some networks such as the French Cyclades.
The solution to that was creating an Internet Protocol, or IP. You might have heard of it. Its fourth version, IPv4, allowed networks to speak the same language and connect to each other. Actually, that protocol was so cool that we still use it today. We're actually running out of IP addresses, and IPv4 will be soon replaced by IPv6, but problem solved, right? Well, we are actually have another problem.
How do information packets travel from one PC to another? There could be different ways to achieve it, but it's important that everybody has the same protocol or speaks the same language, remember?
Just like a French speaker couldn't talk via telephone with a Korean speaker without a common language.
The routing protocol that manages this is called Border Gateway Protocol, or simply BGP, which basically finds the shortest possible route. Assuming that this is a possible network topology, let's say that we want to send a message from A to B. There's more than one path to check, right? We could do ACDB, or ACDEB, or even ACFEB. But assuming that all these links are equally long, then the shortest possible path is ADB, right? Well, BGP is a protocol that finds that shortest path, and that's why it is still used today. But it actually has a problem, and to explain it, let's imagine a scenario. Let's think about an event. One of the best singers of the world will make a performance at a 3 floors fancy building. When people arrive, they see a big entrance, and inside they can walk on a long red carpet that leads to the elevator. Although the place looks very pleasing, with a lot of luxury ornaments and expensive paintings on the walls, there is a problem. The performance will take place on the 3rd floor, and there can only be 4 people inside the elevator at the same time. People can also use the stairs, but as they are formally dressed, it's the night, they prefer using the elevator and a congestion is created. This is just how internet works nowadays. The third floor would be a host or a web page or simply a destination where some users want to send packets to. Using the elevator is what current internet would do. Take the shortest path. That can lead to congestions. Have you ever been playing Minecraft and suddenly it started being laggy? Like you couldn't control your character or move it or do anything? And suddenly you were dead. Well, that's probably latency, and it's mainly due to our internet congestions. So how do we solve this? Well, if we go back to the example of the building, it's pretty simple. Some people should use the elevator and some people should use the stairs. And that's it, less congestions. That essentially means that sometimes we have to take a longer path that is less congested so we can get faster to our destination. And guess what? There is a company that is currently aiming to achieve that. Noia, with its programmable internet.
Let me add some context here. My name is Luciano Bruna. I am an engineer in electronics and I make videos for fun. By the way, I recently got to 1K subscribers, so thank you very much to all of you for that. A couple of years ago, I got really interested in a new emerging market that we can call the internet improving market, if you want. Basically, there are a lot of new companies that are trying to make the internet better, faster, cheaper, safer, get it to new places, solve the last mile problem, etc. And I got so interested in that market that my degree final project was a small contribution to one of these companies. Anyway, as it's a new market, there are gonna be some companies that will be successful, but most of them will fail. And it seems that Noia, the company that I'm talking about in this video, is gonna be one of the successful ones. But only time will tell.
Noia Network's programmable internet aims to let you choose a path for your data packets that might be different than what BGP would choose. That would allow you to have a faster connection and lower latency. This is achieved with the use of two new emerging technologies, one that I've already mentioned, IPv6, and a new one, segment routing. Combined together, they allow a packet to have information about its route on its header, which means you can instruct every packet to take whatever path you choose. To make this work, you must know the network topology. Essentially, you must know which are the participating segment routing routers, which can understand those headers instructions. Let's say that these are the possible segment routing routes. Noia pretends to hold this topology with the use of a distributed ledger to keep everything decentralized and safe. Internet links will be discoverable through the ledger and traded on a decentralized internet transit exchange, the VTEX, using Noia tokens, a cryptocurrency. Once a trade is done, your traffic will be authorized to be sent through and you can program your data to use a certain path over the internet.
This programmable internet thing they are creating will be available when they release their app. Basically, you're gonna be able to download their app on your phone, and by clicking on a button, you're gonna be connected to the whole network, and that's it. And according to their webpage, the app will route your traffic through this network they are creating, taking into account the fastest and most optimal routes for every request you send out, whether you're playing online video games, streaming live content, trading on stock or crypto exchanges, video calling, or taking part in any other online activity that requires a good internet connection with low latency, Noia application will serve you to guarantee the best user experience. Is that too good to be true? I actually don't know. But I think that the best way to find that out is joining the waitlist, which the link is in the description, and only time will tell, as I said. Anyway, right now, Noia has already a test network, which is more of like a decentralized CDN network, that you can already join. And that leads us to the second part of the video, the money part. If you set up what they call a Noia node, which basically consists of opening some ports on the router and installing a small app on your PC, which practically doesn't consume any resources, they're gonna pay you in Noia tokens every week for helping them to test the network. The rules might change, but right now, if you have IPv6 enabled and run their app for 120 hours a week, which means you open the program and you let it open while you use the PC, you're gonna receive 200 NOIAs per week. And as you know, crypto prices are always changing, so it's kind of difficult to explain exactly how much is that. But as a reference, I made about $300, as I said at the beginning of the video, in about 14 months. So considering that this app only consumes your idle resources, I'd say that it's pretty much worth it.
Anyway, these are the steps you need to follow to set up a NOIA node. 1. Register on the NOIA network webpage. 2. Submit and get your KYC approved. 3. Download the NOIA client and set it up. Add your digital wallet address. I recommend using my Ether wallet. 4. Open two ports that by default are the 8048 TCP and 8058 UDP ports. If you have IPv6 enabled, you will receive more coins than if you use IPv4, and that's it. Just wait and they will transfer you NOIA tokens on a weekly basis.
There is a chance that you didn't understand some of these steps, or maybe you have absolutely no idea what I was talking about. If that's the case, then don't worry. There is a link in the description of the video of a full step-by-step guide on how to set up your NOIA node, especially for those who have no idea about cryptocurrencies and blockchain and stuff like that. I decided to not include that in this video because I didn't want it to be eternal. Anyway, if you have questions of any sort, just write them down below and I'll be glad to answer them all. If you like this video, give me a like, which would motivate me a lot, and I'll see you in the next one.